We're back on the video. Wait, hold on. Didn't Nicki Minaj pee on that new diss track? That new diss track. I think I only got life off of the Raggedy Ann part, like the Raggedy how she dragged it. That's when I was doing like, bitch, that's like you key and bitch, but like that's the new thing. That was giving that with the girls, like, which I'm like, Rag, you gotta give that to the girls. It's like it's no shade, and I give respect where it's due. It's no shade that everybody read. First of all, I'm a Kim Dahl fan. You can't take it from me. But I have to just say, like, I have to say, the tragedy song, it's a lot of girls on tragedy right now. It's a lot of girls. And Nicki Minaj just pee on that. You have to just give respect when it's due. I mean, that's the bottom line. You can't take nothing from that lady. Get a lady her life, you guys. No shade. And the reason why I made this video today, this is my celebrity edition, is because I would just put that little thing on my wall on Facebook. And a lot of girls are just going and reading, comment, and going off read, and and I don't even get into the Kim and Nicki whole beef, cause I mean, I just know the queen. That's the queen, so I don't even go back and forth with that. But just because it's on my wall, and, I had to say something about it. You know what I'm saying? But like I said, I live for the Nicki Minaj thing. I live for that line. That bitch gave you what that bitch said? That bitch said, it sucks to have your it's on PayPal or some shit like that. That was cute. I mean, she had a couple of, that was the only two cute little punchline things she did. It was comedy about the situation. You know what I'm saying? And still not fucking with Black Friday, but it was comedy. And that's just Vicky Gotti opinion. And I'm notorious for opinions. Like, I'm the notorious Vicky Gotti. Everyone knows that. It was a big thing. I just want to say, first of all, so let me tell you what happened today. I do not like to keep my viewers posted on what's going on with E. So, y'all, I went to the Real World casting in my second casting call, whatever the case may be, and I think I did good, you guys. I just feel like I kind of stumbled a little bit because it's like, everybody say I'm great, I'm destined for greatness, and my personality is everything, and I'm this, I'm that, and they see me on my own show. I mean, it's so much good, positive feedback I get from you guys, and I love you guys. I thank you so much from all over, but when I went in that casting, it's people just like me. So it's just so hard. They picking everybody from across the world. It's just so hard. Like you don't know how bad I want this. Like I want this world. Like I just need this. I want this exposure. I feel like the real world needs me. You know what I'm saying? I feel like it needs me just because it would be something different. I would give you that energy. I would give you know what I'm saying? I would give you that excitement. I would give you that realness. I would give you all that. I won't be like a typical faggot anyway, because I just hate, don't you hate when a queen's on a show and they just be acting like a queen? I hate that. And I'm not that type of person. I'm gonna give you a regular BNG con butch queen from Queens, Jamaica, Queens, New York. You know what I'm saying? Trying to get on. That's basically what I am. You know what I'm saying? Either you like me or you don't like me, it's no in between with me. That's it. And I say that to say, I want to give a special shout out to my, first of all, I don't never, I want to give a special shout out to all my kids, the Gotti boys, my Gotti sons. I love my little fucking sons. I love my sons. Hold on, you guys. I love my sons so much. If you can still hear me, I love my sons so much. Those are my boys. Like, those are my boys. Like, for real. Like, those are my boys. Special shout out to my little James Caan Gotti. She's now officially Gotti. If I didn't know, now y'all know. Fuck with her, fuck with me. That's how we doing that. Shout out to Quincy Icon. I want to shout out to Eric Milan. Speaking of Eric Milan, so Eric is doing an AIDS walk, you guys. I'm promoting. I think I'm gonna do the AIDS walk with Eric this year. Except the whole Beckham crew, they're doing this big AIDS walk thing. I think it's in May sometime. He's gonna give me all the dates, but that should be hot. Also donating money for funds for HIV, for people who got HIV. And I guess, just learning more about it, you guys, wrap it up, do what you have to do safely. And I see people making videos now. I see people reading. I see people throwing out people sick and stuff. That's just so tacky to me and disgusting. Like, don't do that. Yes, you don't know what no one's going through. Are you going to be that harsh? Like, for real, it's never that deep. You know what I'm saying? I don't even have to name our names. Like my viewers and y'all and people who know me and that's around the scene, I know who's just tacky. Like you just know when you're a tacky girl. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, I know that already. I don't have to sit here and jot out names. That's not me. I don't throw out names. You know what I'm saying? Either you read between my lines or you don't. And I also want to shout out to Imani. Imani's been glowing to me. That's a pretty dark-skinned babe. I have to give Imani my life. Like, that's just a pretty dark-skinned babe. And I've just been looking at Imani lately and been living. Work, Imani, Ms. Rahi. No shade. But anyway, back to some more gossip. You know what? Where's Khalif and motherfucking Lil Wayne's beefing there? I don't know if that got the beats. But I just feel like, Wiz, are you trying to get your name off of Weezy? Like, that's my husband. Leave Weezy alone. For real. It's beef going back and forth with them. It's cute. I guess it's cute publicity, whatever it is. But they beefing. At the end of the day, Lil Wayne stays. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, Lil Wayne slayed. And I want to say rest in peace. It was a Versace. He modeled for Versace, Louis Vuitton. And I think, was it Gucci? It was one, but he died today. He got hit by, it was a hit and run. And I like, he was going to visit his family. So shout out to him. Well, rest in peace to him. That's like a tragedy, or it is maybe. So I just wanted to get that off of my chest. And also, I wanted to promote my party. Everyone at party will be April 16th. I will be at Club Secrets Live. Me and Zayday Ms. Raw, he doing it, how we do it. You know what I'm saying? I'm partying like I never party at all. Like, I'm really gonna go in. So come out with me, my cousin Juicy, my VIP girls. I have my guest list. I gotta get my hair did. I still got my blonde shit going on. I just got it shaped up, so it's like, what's up now? And yo, shout out to Chloe, shout out to Paris Gotti, I see you. You know, we're gonna get that interview popping. Shout out to Felicity, sweet, sweet girl, my father Donald, my whole gay family, Roxy, I love you, Asia Balenciaga, one of the baddest bitches on the market. It's not too many. And that's one thing else. Let me just say this real quick. And this is two things that you must not do. This is when Mickey look at you as a not. This is my personal opinion. When you're on Facebook and you're saying who you on a phone with, like I'm on a phone. That's just so naughty to me. Like, do everybody have to know who you're on the phone with? Like, stuff like that is just like, that's a fiend. That's like a fiend of the girls. Another thing, when you're showing off money, that's just like, really? A lot, and I just hate the fact that a lot of girls scream, you make this, you make that, you do this, you got. But every time I come out or I step out, I see pictures, you don't look like money, ma. Like, where's your money going? To me, looking like, first of all, and I always say this, and that's why I feel like I just feel like caring about the situation because I'm old money, I'm old garments. The shit that I was one of the first between me and my girls, like shout out to Dior, Shamar, Chris, Coach. We was like the bad bitches growing up. 16, 17, 18, had that on lock. Miu Miu bags, thousands, like just going in with Miu Miu, Gucci, all the latest, Marc Jacobs, BBC, when that was popping. Everything, we had it all, bitch. And the girls who know my history, they know. I don't even have to, I don't speak about that. You know what I'm saying? But that's, I'm always a dumb bitch. No shade. I'm not really into that right now. I'm into my trendy, shit. But I don't really scream, I make money. Yeah, I make money. I make money. I do what I do. But who's screaming? Who showed off? Like, where do they do that? Like, for real. So please get it together, y'all, for real. That's just the two things you must not do. Like, that's just so late. And it just shows that you're a fiend of a girl. And it just feel like, I mean, like you never had nothing at all. Maybe no shade. Maybe y'all really didn't have nothing, though. Like, maybe. So let me take that back. Maybe some of you guys are just really happy. Maybe you are. I don't know. But this was the celebrity edition of the Vicky Gaddy Show. Please, you guys, comment, comment, comment. I love your comments. Please pray for me to get in this real world show or a reality show or something. I'm destined. I'm hungry. So what's good?